How you doing, people? As Mandy says, we have a duty and obligation to protect the sons and daughters, including your own. Sons, daughters, nephews, nieces, grandsons and granddaughters, they're at risk right now, and your government's complicit in it. Over a three-year period in Scotland, 27,000 sons and daughters have went missing, and there is no answers. And this was verified by a freedom information request by Police Scotland. Now, it came to your attention as well, there's a wee booklet there, the evidence is in it, that 20 constables that work for Police Scotland have been convicted of downloading images, sexual offences against sons and daughters and women. It's also came to our attention, there's still 75 of these scumbags on the street on their job getting paid their wages. So when a constable approaches you, he could be one of the 75 paedophiles that work for Police Scotland, and that's a fact. If you can't trust the police with your sons and daughters, who can you trust? Because you can't certainly trust Nicola Sturgeon and the rest of the ratbags in the Scottish Parliament, because they're corrupt to the core. Now, my job for here, with Mandy, she specialises in sexual abuse trafficking. I specialise in the law, the real law. No, it's been preached to the people of Scotland, England, Ireland and Wales. So let me see if you can open your ears and listen and educate yourself and pay attention. And everything I say here today, I verify in private capacity under full liability. And I'll take any man or woman in any part of the legal system to come here, stand here and call me a liar and I'll destroy you in the public. Now, I take very serious what I do here. I've been doing this for 2 years on the street. I've been doing it for 11 years. I've been locked up numerous occasions. My door's been kicked in. I've been falsely arrested. 2020, I got arrested in Argyle Street for doing the exact same thing here. And the two charges were corrupt, standing speaking to more than two people in a street. Standing speaking in a street. Everybody else was still speaking after I went to Helen Street with a false two charges, kidnapped and held against my will. And the only reason I got the same day is because the people here that stand with us came to Helen Street and caused such a rumpus they had to let me out in bail. Now, there's two jurisdictions in Scotland. There's legal, there's lawful. Legal has no bearing on man or woman. Everybody here, everywhere in this street is a man or a woman, a son or a daughter. You have life. Everything in statutory legislation states person. Person's an entity that's attached to the man or woman. It makes you surety for a driving license. It makes you surety for council tax, income tax and everything else. The system, right through the United Kingdom Corporation, is corrupt. Every legal document printed with the councils, police, everything is unlawful. No illegal. Forget the legal and the illegal. We're talking the law here. Common law. Commit no harm, loss, injury, trespass on property, damage, fraud within a lawful contract, and you have committed no crime. And I've verified it right here now as an honourable man. You have been deceived with Nicola Sturgeon. All these legislations have nothing to do with it. If you look at every legislation, it states person, does not state man or woman, so it does not be applicable to you, but these people have been getting away with this for hundreds of decades, and that's new coming to light with people like myself all over this country. It's fighting for your rights, fighting to educate you. We're not asking for money, we're not putting buckets out, we're giving you information with our time and energy to try and help you understand what's really going on. Nicola Sturgeon and their politicians, everything they passed in the Parliament is passed by 129 people. The other 5 million plus in Scotland didn't consent to that, so it's not applicable. We have to move Sturgeon and every politician out of that Parliament. Get the people, a people government, and that's going to represent the people and not represent themselves and rob the people of their equity. Now, let me tell you about debt collectors. Sheriff, officers that take council tax arrears get into your bank and rob your money, rob your property, steal everything from the people. Unlawfully, no illegally, unlawfully. Now, in the courts, they hire a room. Your sheriff officer get into a list with maybe 200, 300, 400 people on a list. And you get one summary warrant for 8 people when you should be getting a summary warrant for every individual man and woman on that document. Right? You also have in law the right to challenge any debt that people are claiming that you owe. But that doesn't happen because the court system is part of the fraud. The solicitors, stay away from them. Prepare your own cases and fight your own cases. They're drawing you into the legal realm and you get screwed right, left and centre because you don't know your rights. When you give a solicitor in these corrupt courts, administrative hearings, they are not courts. They're all private corporations. Nicola Sturgeon's a private corporation registered in Dun and Bradstreet. John Sweeney's a private corporation registered in Dun and Bradstreet. Check it, you'll see I'm telling you the truth. Patrick Harvey. Hume's a useless, right? That's what I call him. Useless, because that's what he is. And every politician in the Scottish Parliament are private corporations. The Scottish Government is registered as a private corporation. The Scottish Parliament is registered as a private corporation. The NHS Scotland is a private corporation. Police Scotland is a private corporation. That is why you are not getting your rights. You are not getting your care in the hospitals, proper care. Now, we're talking about COVID. What about the people that die of cancer? I lost my father 8 weeks ago because of this. He got him in the hospital and they tried everything to make him take a PCR test and all the rest of the nonsense. And I stood up as a man and I challenged two surgeons and I told him he wasn't taking a PCR test and nobody was going to touch him because his body's his property. Okay. Everything attached to the man or woman is your property. No man and woman in this planet has a right to touch your property without your implied consent. You decide what people do to you, not what they decide. People have to realise this is deadly serious, people. We're not standing here wasting our time. I'm standing here and you might think I'm aggressive, it's not, it's passion, because I'm trying to get a message into people's heads. Everything that you see and what's happening right now is for your benefit. It is not for the people, it is not for the services. We have to make change in Scotland. And the only way we can make change is if the people come together, we expose Scotland, anti-corruption Scotland, and save our children and stand with us and support us. We'll make a change. Because next year I'm going after Sturgeon because she's a rat. Now, I hope you people are taking in everything I'm saying. As I say, the higher a court, and when you get all these debt letters coming to the houses that say your council tax are yours, you get a minimum charge of £78, whatever it is, to every name on that document. So rightly, the sheriff officers are charging you unlawfully and making money out of your deprivation, poverty and hardship, because everybody right now in Scotland is struggling. I don't care what position you hold, even people with good paying jobs that's paying mortgages, paying all their debt, they're all struggling and it's terrible. We the people should be having a comfortable life, unhindered, and not bullied by corporate criminals like Sturgeon, Boris Johnson, and Numpty. He's on his way out the door. He's going bye-bye shortly because he's a criminal at the highest level. Now, people, once you get the letter for the court and the debt letter for the sheriff officers, you get a charge certificate. And anybody's got debt, we walk and love. Scott and Co are still in the partner what I'm talking about. It tells you that the debt is in Her Majesty's name. So when did Her Majesty say that you owed a debt? Get up and tell you that you owe a debt. You don't have a contract with her. This is how they escape liability. Sheriff officer, sheriff, procurator fiscal, solicitor, parole officer, prison officer. These are fictions that don't exist. Every uniform a man or a woman wears, it's a man or woman that causes the thought of harm. Know the office or the corporate name like Glasgow City Council, JD, Renfrewshire Council, Edinburgh Council, Police Scotland, NHS Scotland. There is no man or woman called that. And this is a bit you people have to waken your eyes up and pay attention. You're being deceived, you're being robbed, you're being bullied unlawfully, and it needs to stop. People have to waken up. Please waken up and listen to what you're told. We're the truthers. We don't give myth information. We stand here and try to educate you with our energy and our time. I've got better things to do with my time. And the only reason to be truthful I'm here is one of my last wishes for my father was that I carried on because I've done this for 11 a year to get remedy for the people. And let me tell you, if my father would have told me the other side, don't dare, I would have stopped and walked away. But this is too important because sons and daughters and the people are at risk. But this government, these corporations, and it's wrong. Now, people think when they get into your bank account that they've got a court order. It's nothing to do with the court, because I've had it verified for two civil departments, Paisley and Glasgow, two criminal departments. The charge certificate, and I can verify this, has nothing to do with it. It's a debt collector that creates the certificate and deceives you to rob you for your equity. And guess what, people? It's not a court order. The same company give you the charge certificate, give you their order. They create it. It's nothing to do with a court. It's a fraud. It's a scam. And people can challenge that. And the banks are complicit in the scam, because when you get into the bank, it's the all capital name. When you fill in forms or any legal forms in the legal system, legal society, it has to be filled in boxes most of the time, or it has to be filled in with a black all capital name. The all capital name is somebody is dead. Now, I can verify Scotland's People website, where you get an extract of the birth certificate. Mandy's got it there somewhere. You have an entity ID. And guess what, people? It's the all capital name. When did you be given an all capital name? This document here, people, is mine. I've told numerous people, I've just took on the Lord Advocate of Scotland, the court manager, Glasgow Sheriff Court, and the clerk of the court, the highest clerk in the court. Now, since I've took on the Lord Advocate, everybody's applied to Scotland's People for a birth certificate. Does he get the receipt anymore? And that only happened for this week, when I served documents on the Lord Advocate, Dorothy Bain, the scumbag that she is. Right? This is my receipt that I got me, the extract of the birth certificate. Search extract statutory births. Entity ID. You have an entity ID, right? And this entity ID that Mandy forgot to mention is the entity ID when you get your sex education with your wins, and they're going to ask for this ID so they can individually manipulate each number and each son of God, right? Surname, Sproul, all capital. I don't have an all capital name, right? Forename, Robert, all capital name. Do you have an all capital name? Are you a person, right? Now, at the bottom of this it says, any certificates have to be, anything that's produced with these certificates have to have the living, no person, living individuals' permission. There's a language going on here, people, that use people don't understand. It's called legalese. A prime example is if you're standing with the police and they say, do you understand the charge? 99.9 people would say, I understand. Well, what you don't understand is, as soon as you do that, you give them joinder and you stand under their authority. So anytime anybody asks you, do you understand, just keep telling them, no, don't understand. One constable says, what do you not understand? I said, I don't understand then. I said, you could draw 10 pictures on a wall and I'll still tell you that I don't understand. Because they want joinder. When you interact with these people, now, board there, constable officer, does anybody know what the difference is? Constable, common law, protect and serve, keep the peace. Officer, enforce statutes and acts created by the criminals in the Scottish Parliament. That isn't a law, it's a rule, like COVID rule. There's a difference between the word rule and law, and that is not law. When they wear, when you interact with these people in the green vests or the green long sleeve jackets, you are interacting with a corporate policy enforcer. No law enforcer, policy. Their purpose is fines and fixed penalties. That's what they're there for, extort money out of the people, and I verify that, because I've been arrested that many times, I'm fed up. Three times I've got myself to jail in Helen Street to get an answer I couldn't get. And one time a copper came to the cell and he says, that was necessary for you to get locked up. I says, it was necessary for me to get locked up. And he asked me why. I says, because there's an answer I don't have. And thanks to you for locking me up here unlawfully, kidnapping me and holding me against my will, you gave me that answer. I thank you very much. I'll be at court Monday and I'll be back on the street. So now go away, shut that hatch and let me go back to sleep so I can sleep. They're liars. Don't think when these people are talking to you with a smile on their face and they're trying to be nice to you, that they're on your side. They'll just try to throw you in a conversation without your consent and penalise you. And that's a fact. Everything they do under an act of breaching their oath, and they can get up to 5 years for that. They don't know that. We're trying to do a document to prove this, because all these posts are going to get put on notice shortly for what they're doing to the people. Yay. Anyway, people. Yeah. I would like to take time to thank for the people that stood and listened and give me your time to be heard. And everything I'm telling you, on my daughter's life and on my granddaughter's life, is true. I don't need to lie to you. I'm not here to lie to you. I'm here to educate you with my time and my knowledge. And hopefully some of that knowledge you have today will go to your mind and you start asking. Do your research, people. Don't take our word for it. We're giving you the evidence. All you have to do is research it and we'll never be shut down. Thank you, people.
Next week, as you know, is Christmas. Sad time for myself and other people.
We are going to come into Glasgow. I'll be doing a live video on Facebook. We'll probably have Argyle Street. It might be quiet, we don't know. But we are going to push the issue here because we are protecting people's rights, especially sons and daughters. Now, I want to highlight a point here. Look at the size of this woman. Over 50 police officers surrounded her in Partick. She was waiting for a witness to come to witness the event. They smashed the window into her face. She jumped to the passenger side of the car, jumped out, they grabbed her and decked her. She was wearing a pair of shorts, and the time they were finished with her, it was turned into a skirt. That's what Police Scotland do to people like us that tell you the truth and stand and fight for your rights. You people have to come and support us, support you, educate you to your rights, and stop the tyranny and the crimes with Sturgeon and the rest of the parasites in the Scottish Parliament is passing fake laws and abusing power. Next year I'm going after Sturgeon, because this system for 11 years has destroyed my family. Social services took my sister, son and boy into care based on lies and fraud. No crime in law. Two social workers, Dorothy McCallop and Ross McAllister, lied. The sheriff, all the sheriffs in Paisley Court are corrupt to the core. I went in and got to jail for videoing with a hidden camera to expose that it wasn't a court of law, it was an administrative hearing. 7 days later, my door went in and they locked me up for the weekend. I get back out and I fought the trial. I'm still here because I don't back down, because I know who I am and what I am. I have rights and I'm a man, a living, breathing, flesh and blood man, the same as everybody else, living, breathing, flesh and blood. Please, people, look at the leaflets. If you've heard any information or you know anything or somebody knows something, come forward. We need to get remedy and answers for the family that the Police Scotland are denying their right to know what happened. I would like to take time to thank everybody that stood and listened, and I hope you take on board what we say. We don't give misinformation. We try to educate you. We don't ask for money. We don't ask for donations. That's not what we're about. We just want to get you people to understand you have rights. You don't have duties, obligations and responsibilities to a legal system, legal society. And that's a fact. Thank you, people. Yeah.